Why is cache preloading important for improving the performance of your site? Preloading ensures your visitors get the speedier, cached versions of your site right away. WP Rocket automatically takes care of this, and in this video, we'll see how. When you activate WP Rocket for the first time, the plugin begins generating cached versions of your content right away. When you activate the sitemap-based cache preloading option, sitemaps generated by popular SEO plugins will be automatically detected and preloaded. You can also specify your own sitemaps by entering their URLs in the Sitemaps for Preloading text field. These sitemaps will be preloaded after the homepage URLs with no duplication, whenever you change WP Rocket settings, when the cache lifespan expires, and whenever you click the preload link from the admin toolbar or on the WP Rocket dashboard. It's important to note that preloading doesn't work if you have a separate mobile site or use cookie-specific cache files. After a preload has been triggered, you'll see a notice at the top of your screen. If you want to halt the process, click the button to stop preloading. If you think preloading isn't working on your site, first check to see whether or not cache files are being generated after you click the preload button. To do so, you can use either the file manager in your web hosting control panel or an FTP client. Then, navigate to the WP-Rocket folder, which is inside the cache folder within your WP-Content directory. Within the WP Rocket folder, you should see a subfolder named after your domain. Inside that folder, you'll find any cache files that have been created. Now, select the preload cache link from the WP Rocket admin toolbar. Wait a few moments, then refresh the cache folder in your file manager. You should see new files added. You can check the date to see when they were created. To make sure preloading works as expected, check whether or not WP Cron can run on your WordPress site using the WP Cron Status Checker plugin. After activating the plugin, visit your dashboard and look for the WP Cron Status Checker widget. You should also make sure that your homepage and sitemap URLs are publicly reachable, your sitemap URL is entered correctly on the preload tab, and that your security measures are not blocking access to your site. Now, if you get a curl error 28 notice, this usually indicates a slow server response time. If that happens, you should get in touch with your hosting provider and ask how to upgrade your server's performance. In any other case, feel free to contact our amazing support team directly in the WP Rocket admin panel. They'll be glad to help out. And thanks for watching.